Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to Old Times. So I've got the international there, and it's just skipped around that tree. He is now ploughing this field, and I've done that headland, and I've done the other headland up there. He does go quite a ways off the end of the field each time, because of his very poor turning circle, but he is doing the job. So I'm going to let him carry on with that. The sugar beet harvest is underway. The eggs, the eggs are producing slowly, but the wool is ready. We have 100% wool. So what we want to do, actually, is we want to go and get the wool. We have one sugar beet trailer full of sugar beet, and that sugar beet harvester is half full. So we've nearly actually finished this, but before I do any of that, the weekly question, which combine do you want me to get? Do you want me to get the Bizon Gigant Z083? Or do you want me to get the Rostselmash Don 1500A? They are both absolutely fantastic mods, really well built, a lot of attention to detail. I'm thoroughly impressed with both of them. And I may even end up at some point getting both of these combines. But for now, I will get the one that you asked me to get. So that one's 4,100 litres. That one, I can't remember how much is in the tank. I think it's roughly the same. So yes, it's your vote, it's your game. Head down below into the comment section, let me know which combine you want me to get. Now the other thing, I need a front loader, and ignore the tractors and all of that, some of those. Right, this one, 6,850. We might actually be able to buy that one outright. I also need a conveyor. I'm going to use this one here. This one will take sugar beet, I think. Yeah, there's the beet. So it'll take sugar beet. This one here has had extra things added to it. Someone modded it further. Happy looser. But for now, we can just take this one, which is quite an old looking conveyor, and it does fit with the map. Conveyors were used a lot. You had one very common that you would have found a front mounted one. Usually they were trailed, but I thought we could use this one as it's a familiar one. It is well built. I'll try a trailed one another time. Okay, how's that? I want to get out of there. Right. That one is nearly ready. So what I'm going to do, actually, see, I'm wondering if I should, let's just hire it. Let's just go for it and hire the front loader, the Volvo. There he is. Right, so see, he's only 500 to hire for the for a day. So we get that one, and the conveyor, I don't think I can afford to buy that one either, so I'll hire the conveyor. And I also want to get a fork. There, pallet fork. I'm going to buy the pallet fork. Let's go to there. And front loaders, because it's front loader stuff that we've got to use for this one. So there we go. The pallet fork, 800 euros. I can get that one. There we go. And now, I'll tell you what, we'll do that first. Let's do that bit first. I will just wait for this one to fill up and I will empty him out. And then I will sell these two trailerfuls and then we can get on with the next bit. So we will get that pallet of wool and we'll take that to the spinnery as soon as I've done this. And then I've got something else, which is an absolutely amazing mod that I have just installed. It is brilliant and I'm really looking forward to being able to use it. I'm quite excited about this one. Right, I've tipped out that. We've got a little bit more money. The sugar beet harvest is actually almost finished. We've only got a little tiny bit left and then we will actually be completely done. So let me just get this. So first of all, we're going to go and get the turning. See, this one actually turns properly. We have a decent turning circle on it. So we'll go and get the pallet fork, and then we'll come back and we'll get that pallet of wool, and we're going to take it to the spinnery. Now, where is the spinnery? That's the next question. Take a look at the map here. Oh, yeah, it's right up the top. So we've got to go all the way up near the windmill up there to take our pallet of wool. So I suppose as we only seem to be producing one pallet per day, it's not the fastest production with only 100 sheep. If we get more sheep, and so we're producing quite a bit more wool, we might have to get a trailer or something like that to help sort things out a little bit. And then once we've done that, we're going to come back, we're going to get that conveyor, and we're going to put it in position over the potato, well, one of the potatoes or the sugar beet, one or the other. And once we've done that, and it's all ready to go, let me just, wrong way, there we go, pick that one up. Yeah, see, I think it's dynamic attachment or something like that. I can't remember exactly what it was called, but yeah, it does move around a little bit. But at least it does stay on there, and it's not going to come flying off or anything. Let's go in cab to do this little bit. Yeah, I've got a mod which I've just found. It's actually, I was hunting around for it and I found it quite a little while ago, but I could not get it to work and I had all sorts of troubles with it. And eventually, I did get some of it to work, but not all of it. And then imagine my surprise when yesterday I was perusing mods here and there and I found on the main Farming Simulator website the mod that I was looking at. It's just only just turned up on there. So if those of you who keep up to date probably know what it is. It's a small set of lorries. They're actually Russian ones. And there's quite a bit of detail in the mod itself about what they did historically and awards they won and stuff like that. And it is very detailed. It's absolutely fantastic. And it's absolutely perfect for this map. It's like they designed it with this map in mind. So yeah, thank you very much for whoever made that mod. It is brilliant. It is just what I've been waiting for. Let me just bring that down a little bit. It's getting this lined up is the key. There we go. Right, I think that's right. So let's do this bit in cab. There we go. Pick that one up. It does stick sometimes. It kind of, you know, the floor grabs it a little bit. Now the only issue is I can't see where I'm going. So I am going to have to come out of cab for this little bit. And as I'm only driving up the road, I'll go down here and then I will... Which way do I want to go? I think I want to actually head, because if we have a look at the map here, I want to head out this way. There's another egg cell point back there if we go up past field 4. Sort of go in the roundabout route, but no, we won't do that. We'll go up this way and take the most direct route that we can. Think we want to come up here. Job to tell. Yeah, if we come up here just below field 1, we can come out underneath. I'll get up there a second and then we can see how much we get for selling this pallet. There is the spinnery, and on our left, just come in around here, as we got a load of forestry there. We've got a couple of big areas of forestry and there's a huge great field of grass up over there that we will be using later on. But first of all, let's see how much we get for this one. It's going to be 2,384 euros. That's actually pretty good. That's actually pretty... That is a very reasonable amount of money, that is. I quite like that. Okay, so now I'm thinking that maybe we should get more sheep. Another 100 sheep. We could do this trip fairly regularly. If we get a trailer or something that we could stick the wool pallets on. Maybe a small auto load trailer. I really don't like having to stick stuff onto various trailers without an auto load feature. We'll see. I'll think about that. Anyway, I'm going to set up the conveyor belt next. Right, I've got the conveyor belt here, and I'm just going to bring it into the heap, lower it down. I'm going to leave it attached to the Volvo because we'll probably want that on there later on. It's getting it set to the right position down like that and just up slightly. Right, I'll turn that one off a second. Now the machines that I said that I was going to get, and they don't show up in the rest of it. They show up under the miscellaneous section, which is why I couldn't find them for ages as well. We've got these. Okay, I don't know what that is. The GAZ 52 and the GAZ 53, right? This one, you got all of this detail here. 1966 this started out, and that one there is a 75 horsepower. Then it gets a bit more powerful, the 120 horsepower, but that was in the 80s that one was, so technically we can't use that one. That's 10,000. That is the only one that seems to be appropriately priced. Everything else seems to be very, very, very cheap, which is a bit of a shame. We've got a four-wheel drive one here. I don't know when that one came out, but my favorite one is this one. Four-wheel drive, all-terrain vehicle. And I'm just going to assume that that is the newest one of the lot. And it is safe for us to use these two. So I'm assuming that we can use this one here, the GAZ 6611. And then you've got all of these different things that go with it. And these are fantastic. And this one, these two here, they a bread van for bakery products. And this one takes canned foods and all sorts of stuff. I'm assuming that mixes in with a mountain of different mods that are out there for like making different things. And this one transports liquid manure. So we won't really use those two. There's a fuel tanker there. Fuel assemblies from 1971. This one is a trailer for transporting fish and water. So, I mean, we might use it for the water. It's got a sprayer as well. So I think it would fit well having the four-wheel drive lorry. It's either that one or that one. I just like this lorry better. I just like the sound of it. So we got a sprayer that I would like to use. It's got some... Oh, no, those are for the international, those are. That's it. So, yeah, we won't get the sprayer right now, but we are going to get this trailer. I'm actually going to get three of these trailers. Two, three. And then this one is for silage. Yeah, for silage, forage, hay, and straw. It doesn't actually pick it up at all. All it does is you can tip it in there. This one here, you go and get your seed from your silos, and then you take it out to the field, and you fill your seed drill at the field with it. So you don't actually have to pay for filling your seeder. You just use your own corn to do it, which is a really nice touch. We might try that one later on. And then we got the dumping platform. This one is only, it's the same size as our other trailers, but obviously this machine's a fair bit faster. So I'm going to get a few of these. Now, the default color is blue, and I'm thinking, actually, I'll go for one default color, and I'm going to get a selection of colors to make it look like a bit of a mishmash affair. So we'll get a green one, we'll get a yellowy one, and we'll get a... Let's get that color. I don't really know what you'd call that color. An odd color. Did I actually buy this one? I don't think I did. So let's buy that one as well. Right, and I'm going to do something that I never do. I'm going to jump from one to the other. I never actually do that while I'm filming, but I want to now because I'm really impatient and I want to get to these things. So this is our machine, right? The GAZ 6611. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful machine. Get in. And I'll have a look. You've got a couple of options here. You've got wipers, mirrors, a spotlight seeker, which I haven't really been, but then I haven't tried it at night time yet. I haven't tried that at night. Have a look in the cab. It's well made. It's accurate. It is very, very simple, but this is an old Russian classic, and they believed in simple, robust stuff that was going to last for many, many years. And now we're going to start it up and listen to this. There's a bit of a rumble. Actually, it's quite quiet, to be honest. It's quieter than it was last time I was listening to it. It's got a bit of a roar when he's driving around, which is brilliant. It really makes it sound like he's putting in some effort to driving. So you drive back in underneath here, and it does the same with all of these. It works like the Eco Variant thing. And the, I think it's the IT runner as well. That one does the same. So we've got our tipper here. This one holds 4,500, which is the same as our trailers. But you probably noticed that I got several of these, and I'm going to line them all up. And that's going to be the next thing, is I got to chain all of these together. And I can go quite fast, so I will be able to get to my destination fairly quickly once I've got them all chained together. So let me just back up here a second. And this is where I'm going to regret getting this manual attachment mod, isn't it? So I'll get that one on there, and then I will get... I think we'll put the yellow one on next. Yeah, we'll go in order. So back up here, and then back in under there. I will just show you this first two, and then off-screen I will go on and get the rest of them all attached together so that we've got a great big long road train. And I have actually seen a picture many years ago of something similar to this. And he had, I think it was like 8 trailers on the back. It wasn't going very fast, admittedly. But he still had a road train. This was in old Soviet Russia. And it did look like it was going. You know, it was chugging away. And he had, I'm sure it was 8 trailers. I'm absolutely certain it was. Right, now I need the help up so that I can make sure that I attach the correct one. There we go. Get rid of that a second. So I'll take this one. All machines and tools from FAR are currently on sale. The offer lasts for another 42 hours. Is there anything that we want to buy? Sales is that Cavernland one. And let's go through and see if there's anything here that we want to buy. Right, well, that's the silage. We're going to want one of those, aren't we? We've already got a baler. We'll see. Not quite sure. Right, I'm going to take this one out there, and then I'm going to spend a bit of time getting the rest of them attached together. You've seen how they join up now. And then I'll get back to you when I've got my little road train all ready to go. That's the last one on. And I'm just going to bring it out here, and we'll attach it to the front of these two. You can, with each of these trailers, you can just tip them right wherever they happen to be. I don't know if it has a normal tipping option as well as this. I haven't actually tried that yet, but it is something that we're going to be trying in a minute. So you can just leave that one up in the air if you want to, which is a nice little touch, actually. There's not very many trailers you get that you can just manually tip them wherever you happen to be. I don't know if that means that the grain would all sort of come out and tipple over the ground. But I've got all of these trailers all lined up, ready to go. Just need to back up and get that last one hooked on. There we go. Climb out and manually attach. No, I don't want to detach that one. I want to attach that one there, like that. Right, so now we've got our little road train underway. Look at that. Brilliant, isn't it? I'm not actually sure. Yeah, I can see it. So it does actually show them all up down in the bottom corner as well. You can see all of them. He's a little bit slow because there is a tremendous weight that he's got in him here. But this is fantastic. This is absolutely brilliant. Look at this. And he sounds like he's really grunting with it. He's really pulling. Our oilseed rake is going to be ready soon as well. He is really going. Ooh, ooh, steady. Forgot to turn there. I got too excited. Forgot to turn. So, yeah, I've got four trailers worth here. So I can take 18,000 in one load. Okay, that's not a huge amount. And they are quite cheap. We're just going to say that, you know, nobody else wants them and we get them from a farm sale or something like that. Now, why isn't that loading up? That's the next thing. Let's get into our Volvo and see what this is doing. Assuming it's because... Have I not got it in the right place? Yeah. It sort of needs to get to an attach point. Let's climb out of there. Get into this one. And move forwards now so that the next one will load up. So yeah, we do have this one here. I wasn't actually planning to use this one to move all of my crops because it's only 18,000 at a time and we do have quite a lot of crops. So I just kind of wanted to get this one to show you what it's all about, and I want to keep the lorry. I might actually change the lorry for a different one. Because it's so cheap, it's kind of, we can just, you know, call it a rental type thing, I guess. But I definitely want to try that one. And I might try this one here as well. This is 122. It's another four-wheel drive one. These are more road vehicles. And they are good. They're not quite as powerful. They're all around about the same power, I suppose, actually. This one would be good for silage. This holds 10,000 litres. That's going to be really good for doing silage if we got something to run alongside. We got the milk tanker, which is really going to be useful because... obviously when we get that B mod, we're not going to be wanting to sell the milk at midnight. We're going to be wanting to transport it away. And we got the sprayer. So we got a few things that I want to try with this one. I'm just going to test it out for this episode for seeing what it does here. I want to go that way round. I'm trying to see where the trailer is. There we go. Right. There is 18,000. And which way do I want to go? Right, you can feel the strain of it. He's going quite slow. He is straining a bit, but he does build up a bit of speed. This is faster than the tractors. I do actually have to slow down a bit when I come round the corners. Oops. Listen to him roar. Let's go in cab for this a little bit. I'm going up this way. I really like this. This thing is a lot of fun. It's just the sound of it. It just makes you feel like he's really doing something. Because the lorries, the sound of them is not that great. So the Tatra Phoenix that I'm going to use for moving most of my crops is not as good as this. This is way better than that Tatra Phoenix. Even though the Tatra does take a lot, and it is a good mod, It is a good... Oh, that's my timer to say that I've actually run out of time. I got so excited for doing all this that I've run out of time. So let's tip this one out. So he tips straight back. This one does. I don't know if the others do as well. He doesn't... Okay, he doesn't actually like tipping out. Because he tips the wrong way and the back of the trailer gets caught up. Let's go there and we'll do the next one. Is he going to tip sideways? Oh, that's gone too far. But we are selling. Let's just let that one tip out. So he goes sideways. So that one works at least. Is the next one going to work? Well, he's going to go backwards. I don't think you can select which side you tip. It's a little bit of a nuisance because it makes it do that. Right, come forward again. So we're getting 882 euros per load. If I do that there, which way is he going to tip? He's going to come out this side. It just seems to be doing it. It just seems to be randomly selecting which side is going to... I think maybe I just need to be nearer that back end of the pit so it'll tip sideways. Yeah, I'm not quite sure about that. That's given us 9,000 euros now. This is going to take quite a while. Let me just show you the Tatra Phoenix that I was talking about. And we can also do our question. I can show you the question in a second. Right, so Tatra Phoenix, that's 120,000. So I'm going to need to hire that one. But that's 11,000. And then I've also got a tipper to go with it, which is... Where is it? There, that one. And that one takes 19,000. So we can move 30,000 litres at a time, which is a bit more like it. And that... It does look a little... It just kind of looks sleekish, like a more modern one. But... I've got to be honest with you, it's not far out of something from a fair time ago, and I don't really want to move all of my crops just 18,000 at a time with this particular setup that we got here. Unless I can find a bigger trailer that I could pull with an old lorry like this, I will try and have a look before the next episode. But if I can't find something suitable, I'm going to... I'll limit it and I'll say that I'm going to use the Tatra Phoenix and we'll just call that one a suitable model for it. But while we're driving back, and I'm taking the scenic route, I want to go round so that I'm sort of looped underneath the conveyor again, because I'm going to do one more load with this. The question for this week, which I did actually mean to do just a second ago, this way, there we go. Right, which combine do you want me to get? Do you want me to get the Bizon Gigant, which is 79,000 euros? It's a fantastic one, or the Don 1500A. This is a Rostselmash combine. Again, a fantastic mod. They are both superb mods. I can't fault either of them. So which one do you want me to get? The Bizon Gigant or the Rostselmash Don 1500? It's your vote. It's your game. Head down below into the comment section. Let me know which one you want. So while I'm loading this up, we'll just load a little bit of this one up. It's a nice circuit that I can drive. If I could just get some bigger trailers... I would really like to be able to use this mod to do it, but it's just going to take so long doing this at just 18,000 a time. I don't really want to put more trailers on. I think 4 is plenty for this map. I know I've seen that picture of one pulling 8 trailers, but I feel that I don't feel that would fit with this particular map, because it was in an area that was quite level and lots of straight lines as well. So anyway, if you've enjoyed watching this episode, please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.